on Sword in the Stone, Mr. Richter. I made him a wobblehead because, you know, he was always, you know, he ran that castle and had all the authority, and when he talked, this is way of doing it really is self-assured.
Oh, no, you don't. I'm running this place, and if you think you're going to fiddle with my schedule, you'd better pack up your bag of tricks and be gone.
Let's take the sheriff of Nottingham and Robin Hood. He's a big, pompous oaf who is very satisfied with himself and very good, you know, feels real good about everything, and especially about himself, you know. Well, so he has a real bouncy way of walking.
As the taxes due, and the taxes is due.
You see these things in people and you file them away in your mind somewhere.
Milt hasn't done much drawing since his retirement in 1976 after 42 years as an animator. A single drawing has no voice. A single drawing is not animation.
I actually don't really particularly care to draw. It's always been work for me. And what I love is, where I get my kicks is to get that performance on the screens.
Power. Me?
One of Milt's favorite performances was Thumper the Rabbit in Bambi. 5-year-old Peter Bain was Thumper's voice.
That was kind of a nice thing because he couldn't remember his lines, you know. You had to feed him a few words at a time, you know. Mm-hmm. See, that's the only way you could do it. And you say he doesn't walk very good, does he? You know, you could say that.
He doesn't walk very good, does he?
Thumper?
Yes, Mama.
When Peter fluffed the line, Milt made it part of the scene.
If you can't say something nice, don't say nothing at all.
A character's voice can set the stage for an animator's performance. Such was the case with George Sanders, the voice of the tiger, Shere Khan, in The Jungle Book.
They were thinking of a kind of a Jack Palance type, you know, a straight, evil character who was going to kill this kid, you know, and maybe enjoy him for dinner, you know. And so anyway, Ken Anderson made one drawing that he was thinking of a basal rathbone, kind of a supercilious, above it all tiger. They started looking around, and he finally got latched on to George Sanders, and he turned out to be just absolutely perfect.
I'd like a word with you, if you don't mind.
Shere Khan, what a surprise.
Yes, isn't it? I just dropped by. Forgive me if I've interrupted anything.
Oh, no, nothing at all.
I thought perhaps you were entertaining someone up there in your coils. Who is it, Carl?
I was just singing to myself.
Indeed.
He grabs him by the throat and then scratches him with his claw up his nose, up his nostril, you know, and it's just terrible, but he's being so terribly polite and sympathetic.
A trust in me.
No, I can't be bothered with that. I have no time for that sort of nonsense.
Some other time, perhaps.
Perhaps.
Milt's final performance was one of his best. He drew most of Madame Medusa in The Rescuers, and he did it without using a live-action model, though he did get help from Geraldine Page, Medusa's voice.
Well, Geraldine Page is she's an absolutely magnificent actress. She has such a range to her voice too. She goes into from falsetto to a deep growl, you know, and she has a tremendous range.
You get down there and find the big diamond, or you will never see that teddy again.
She has a marvelous feeling for comedy.
Brutus! Nero, stop that infernal racket! kill it, kill it.
See, I saw quite a few of her pictures, too. I saw one with, I think Paul Newman played opposite. It was called The Sweet Bird of Youth, I think. And there's a place in there where he tries to get near. She's on the telephone, and he tries to get near her, and she sticks her foot in his chest, you know, to keep him from away from the telephone. And I always remember that.
Poor Teddy. I'll just keep him up here with me where he'll be safe.
Give me back my teddy bear. He's mine. He's mine.
It was an awfully cruel thing to do and write in character with her.
If you get Milt Kahl to sit with a sketch pad for an encore, you see the fierce intensity that made him a virtuoso among animators. When Milt Kahl takes an encore, he brings a lot of characters back on stage.
Come on, everybody. Here we go!
On to the theater! Hi, diddly-dee! A night of life for me! A heist of cattle, a silver cane! A watch of gold with a diamond chain! Hi, diddly-day! A night of life is gay! It's great to be a celebrity! A night of life for me! A night of life for me. A heist of cattle, a silver cane. A watch of gold with a diamond chain. I'm diddly day. A night of life is gay. It's great to be a celebrity. A night of life for me.
Bravo, bravo. An extraordinary performance.
By the end of his career at Disney, Milt Kahl set standards so high, only he could reach them.
Geez, if you don't have something to aspire to, well, what have you got? You know, you have to have high standards. I think that's part of any profession. You have to... God, if you don't aim high, well, you're not going to get anywhere.